Angela from SexistMagazine.com and here at the Warped Tour 2010 in Mansfield, Mass. This is Derek from Mayday Parade. How are you?
I'm great. How you doing?
I'm awesome. Minus the heat. It's kind of hot out there.
Really? It's not that bad. Well, I guess now we're under the big press area, but I mean, we're from Florida, so I guess we're kind of used to the heat, and I guess today's not as bad as some days, but it is hot out there. So.
Yeah, well, I'm not from Florida, so I'm not used to it yet. I saw you guys at the Journey's Backyard Barbecue a few months ago in Peabody, and your stage presence was just absolutely incredible. You had the whole crowd captured.
All right. Thank you so much.
Oh, so do you guys perform any, like, you know, pre-show type of rituals just to kind of get that energy?
Yeah, I mean, the only thing that we really do is we, like, right before we go on stage, we've done this at every single show we've ever played. We kind of like just get it like huddle in a circle, and we have like a bunch of kind of like words of encouragement we say or whatever, and then we count them. We put our hands in and we count to three and we yell bangarang, which I really don't even remember why we started doing it, but it's from the movie Hook. Hook's my favorite movie, and we now have bracelets that say bangarang. I don't know if you see, but this yellow bracelet shit, say bangarang that we sell, but. That's about it. And then everyone just shows up and has fun, so.
That's awesome. Now, there's been a lot of talk, a lot of controversy and talk about your new video, Kids in Love. Do you guys have anything, any regrets, or even if not regrets, just anything you'd like to say sort of in defense of the video?
Yeah, no. We don't have any regrets. No, it's something that we just wanted to try something different and do a different kind of video, you know? And, so the director came up with that idea, and we liked it, and went with it, and it's cool. I think it's a really neat video, and I think that both versions, I think the censored version and the uncensored version are both really cool, obviously, depending on which is more appropriate for you, they're both really cool. So, yeah.
I love it. It's one of my favorite videos I've seen from any band. It just makes me want to jump in a car.
That's right. Thank you.
Now, what is the story behind your song, Miserable at Best?
Miserable at Best is kind of a long, complicated story, but what do you mean to, what are you trying to figure out here?
Just kind of inspirations as well as any, as much personal meaning as you're willing to tell. Of course, you don't want to pry or anything, but...
Yeah. I mean, all of our songs are about personal things and stuff. We used to have a member of the band named Jason, and he and I used to do the writing together, and, that song is actually about his ex-fiance, very complicated, but that he and I wrote, so it's kind of complicated, but that's the basic idea, so, yeah.
And what has been your most rewarding experience as a band?
It's hard to say. It's really hard to say. Like, there's been so many things, even just, like, being on Warped Tour for the whole summer, you know, when we're coming to Warped Tour as a kid, and I'm dreaming about being on it, you know, so that's amazing, just being able to do what we do and have a lot of people care about us, I don't know, it's awesome. So.
What is a habit or story or something that people would be interested to find out about you?
I'm vegetarian, I'm pretty simple, I'm like the most simple person in the world, I don't know.
Alright, so then what's your favorite vegetarian dish?
That's hard to say. One thing that's awesome is that on Warped Tour right now, they have catering for lunch and dinner every day, and they have awesome vegan catering. They have, like, obviously regular stuff too, and they also have a bunch of vegan stuff, and it's delicious. It's so good every day. But I don't know, there's a lot of really good. To this day, I still absolutely love cheese pizza. It's like my favorite thing in the world. But I try not to even really eat that much cheese, so I try not to do as often as I can. But every now and then I do. So.
I'm a vegetarian too, and you always end up eating like a lot of dairy.
Yeah. And I try not to. I try to. And this is kind of really good to change stuff. So I love cooked vegetables. So yeah.
Right. So what would you say is the best venue you've played at, and why?
I don't know. There's a lot of different venues that we love for different reasons. I don't know if there's been, like, one that's the best, you know? House of Blues shows are always a lot of fun. There's great venues to play. There's just so many. It's really, it's hard to, like, pick one, you know?
And do you have, what would you say is your best fan experience?
I don't know. Same thing. It's hard to just, like, pick one. There hasn't really been one. Our fans have done a lot of really awesome things for us. They've made us cool, like, scrapbooks and made us blankets and all different kinds of cool things and gotten tattoos. People have gotten tattoos or lyrics or whatever. And all of that is just, it's great. It's awesome, you know?
Okay, now I just have a few closer silly type of questions.
Okay.
What's your favorite ice cream?
My favorite ice cream has always been cookies and cream. The only kind of ice cream I really ever eat. I love it.
Favorite candy bar?
That one kind of changes sometimes, but it's pretty much always been Fifth Avenue. If you ever had, it's not a very common candy bar, but I love Fifth Avenue. It's a really good one.
What is it?
Basically, it's kind of like a Butterfinger. It's just like a candy bar with like chocolate and like crunchy butter stuff and crunchy peanut butter stuff in the middle. I don't know. It's really good.
And what's your lucky number?
11. 11. Yeah. Yeah.
Favorite website to visit?
I don't go to a lot of websites. Most of I just like check my Facebook and Twitter. Oh, you know what? I love going to fail blogs. I love going to fail blogs.
I haven't seen that one yet.
It's just a really funny... Oh, and YouTube. Always YouTube. I definitely do. I entertain myself for hours going to YouTube and just watching funny videos. I do it all the time. So, yeah.
That was actually going to lead into my next question. I was going to say, what do you do on your downtime?
Yeah, a lot of times just watch YouTube videos. But no, I mean, I don't get on my computer a whole lot. Usually on Warped Tour... I like to just hang out as much as I can. I have my little bike and I ride it around, and I love to ride it around and just hang out with people and have a good time.
Have you ever Googled yourself?
Yeah, I've Googled myself before. I mean, I don't know the last time it was, but I've done it before, yeah.
Anything interesting come up? Like, is it weird, you know?
It is kind of weird. It is weird. But cool.
What? I don't know if you have gotten a chance to go out, but what would be... the band that you would be most excited to see today?
There's so many awesome bands on the tour. The ones that I was really excited about seeing, first of all, there's a lot of our friends on the tour. There's a lot of friends of ours that are in bands on the tour. And a lot of them I'm looking forward to. Pierce the Veil, Warrior Strong are two of the biggest ones. I was really looking forward to Andrew WK, Sum 41, All American Rejects, We the King, Never Shout Never. There's so many good bands. I could really list, you know, a lot.
And then lastly, is there anything you'd like to say to your fans?
Thank you. That's the biggest thing that we can. Thank you, because it, you know, means a lot, you know, for the support. Anyone who's ever listened to us or bought a CD or come to a show or anything, you know, it's cool. We appreciate it.
Thanks so much.